Welcome one more time to Techno Digital School. Today, we will see which are the three main ways to start taking advantage of the potential of Abaqus scripting in a very simple way. I will be using a version of Abaqus 6.14. Before starting to do anything with Abaqus, we're going to comment which is the first of these ways. And it's about macros that will record all the actions that we carry out in Abaqus through the interface in Abaqus Sky in the form of Python commands in a text file. So if we go back to Abaqus, we come to File, Macro Manager, we open the Macro Manager, and we can create a macro. We're going to save it in the work directory, and we are going to call it Part 1, for example. Continue. And from now on, when we can see here recording macro, all the actions that we carry out in Kai in the Abaqus interface will be recorded. So let's create a part, for example. We come here, create part, 3D. We're going to call it bar, for example, deformable, solid. Through an extrusion, we're going to create it. Continue, and we're going to create a bar with a circular section. For example, we click on create circle from point 0, 0, which will be the center, until minus 10, 0, so that it has a radius of 10 units. We can now cancel the create circle action. We have finished the sketch, and we are going to extrude it along 100 units of length. Suppose length is in millimeters, okay? Well, here we have our part already created. To stop the macro, we will simply click Stop Recording, and our macro has been created. We can now create an empty model, start from scratch, and launch this macro, and it would repeat those same actions that we just recorded, as in any other program. Where is this macro? If we go to our working directory, a file called abaqusmacros.py has appeared. If we open this file, what we see first is that it is in Python format. It is a Python script and has created a function that is actually our macro. And within that function, we see lines that correspond to the actions that we have performed to create that part, to create that circular section bar. Here we have circle by center perimeter, that is with the center at 0, 0, the perimeter point at minus 10, 0, and farther on the extrusion of that circle, of that sketch, along 100 millimeters. From here, we could copy these lines into another file, and we begin creating our own script, only adapting, for example, the parameters that have to do with the dimensions of the model, with the properties of the material that we have received, etc. This is the first of the ways, macros, which we also covered in a previous video. The second way is the RPY file, usually called abaqus.rpy, which also records all the actions that we have carried out. However, this RPY file is not available in the student version. This file also appears in the working directory as we carry out any operation directly. It works as a record of all of the operations that we have performed in Abaqus. If we open it, we will see that we have a series of lines, initially with some imports, the creation of the initial blank model, and then if we go down, we have the remaining actions that we have carried out. We have performed all these actions, as we have seen before, to record the macro. Then we have created a blank model again, and finally, we have tested the macro. In fact, here we have the execution of that macro, allabaqusmacros.part1. I'm going to close this window. Let's mesh the part, for example. Go to mesh. We're going to assign a mesh size, for example, of 5 millimeters, quite large. It's just to test it. OK. And we're going to mesh directly. Mesh. Yes. And here we have the mesh. As we can see, to obtain a good quality mesh, we would have to make some typically cross partitions for circular sections in order to have a structured mesh. But we will leave it here for now. Returning to the RPY file, it asks to be updated, so we say yes. And here we have those new actions that we have carried out to mesh the part. As we can see in this case, it's not necessary to tell it to record a macro. Simply, all the actions that we carry out will be automatically recorded in this file. The third way is the JNL file. In this file, what's going to be recorded? Only the main actions. And this file is not available either in the student edition. If we go back to Abaqus and save, go to File, Save, let's call it bar, for example. And now we return to the working directory, a file called bar.jnl will appear. Let's open it. And here we have only the main actions that have also been recorded as we were doing them. This file is much shorter because, as we say, only the most important actions have been recorded. What are these actions? The creation of the sketch, the creation of the part, and the extrusion of that part, and the meshing of the bar that we have here below. The rest of the operations, most of which have to do with visualization, are not recorded in the JNL file. Also, the JNL file only appears once we save the model. We're going to continue testing it. We're going to create a material, materials, material 1, mechanical, elasticity, elastic properties, isotropic type. So let's give it, for example, a Young's modulus of 210,000 megapascals and a Poisson's ratio of 0.3. Okay. Let's create a section as well, homogeneous, solid, section 1, continue, and with the material 1. Okay, we go back to the part, and we are going to assign that section, but before assigning it, we're going to create some sets. We double click on sets, we will call this set all, and we will select all the geometry. Done. We already have it. We're going to create another front set with the front face. Done. Let's rotate the view. We can use the F3 key and drag with the mouse. And when we have finished, we hit escape. We double click on sets. We're going to call the new set back. And we're going to take the back face. We already have the three sets that we are going to use to create this complete model. So now we're going to assign the section, section assignments. We're going to choose the all set, and we're going to choose section 1 for this set. That is, our part will be composed of that material that we have defined. Now we only have to go to the assembly and create an instance for this bar, for that part to be within our simulation. Okay, we already have the assembly, we already have the instance, so we see it in this blue color. And we're going to create a step on which we will apply the load in the simulation. Double click on steps, static general, continue. Okay, we leave everything by default as it is. And the last thing we have to do is to apply some boundary conditions. So we double click on BCs. Mechanical, BC1, symmetry, anti-symmetry type, because we are going to fix the back face. For that, we have created the back set. If we highlight it here, we will see this set. Continue. And we are going to choose the pinned option. In other words, we are going to completely fix all the degrees of freedom, all the displacements of that back set. Okay? And now we're going to apply another boundary condition, through which we will introduce the load. Double click on BCs. This time we're going to choose displacement rotation, continue. We choose the front set, continue, and we're going to say that it moves in the Z direction. For that, we will choose U3 and we're going to give it a value of 1. It will move 1 millimeter along the plus Z direction. And there we have it, those arrows that indicate where that displacement is going to take place. Finally, we only have to create the job, so we double click on Jobs for Model 1. We will leave the name it has by default, continue, OK. We leave everything by default and we have our model ready to be launched. We're going to save. We're going to return to the JNL file. It tells us that it has to be updated, and here we have it again. The new lines that have appeared with the creation of the material, the creation of the section, the creation of the sets, we have here all front, back. If we continue going down, we will see all the following actions: the assignment of the section, the instance, the creation of the step, the boundary conditions, and finally the job. Here we have it. So we could simply copy all these lines with Ctrl C in a new file and paste them and save this file. File, save as, and we are going to call it varscript.py. And in this simple way, we already have a script with which we could generate this model of the bar. We can delete these imports because they are repeated. That comment too, we save, and we already have it. Let's test it. Back in Abaqus, we're going to create a blank model as if we were to restart the CAI. And we go to File, Run a Script, and we can run that script that we just created, varscript.py. OK, and we see how with this script we have generated the whole bar model again. We have the part with the geometry and the mesh, material, section, instance within the assembly, the step in which we are going to apply the load, and the boundary conditions, and those boundary conditions that we have finally seen, and even the job at the end, ready to be launched and see what results we get. With this, we have seen the three main ways with which we can directly record the scripts in Python and later adapt them to our needs in a very simple way. This has been all for today, and see you in the next video. Bye.